Calamity. Written by Jared Neely. Chapter 15. Foolish. The weather above was noticeably rougher, the compressed oxygen he breathed in was denser, thinner than the earth below. He continued to inhale it, causing him to become slightly lightheaded. The winds were forceful, hitting him from all sides. Immediately, he fought the overbearing exhaustion growing within himself. Placing his arms against the hardened earth, he suddenly raised onto his wiry legs. He expelled the fresh air, peering across the magnificent summit, at Dead Man's Rocker. Levi was standing at its center, in cold silence, staring back at him. His eyes were dead on him, wondering what had brought him there before the others. Dead Man's Rocker was wriggling against the wind, from side to side, swaying as if it too understood the omen Josiah had brought up moments earlier. The wood rambled against the ropes, creating a horrifying noise, one that gave him instant chills. Levi stood swaying against the rickety boards, unbothered, motionless and unfazed. The canyons underneath him delved deeper than he could see from where he stood observing. "Your brother's down below, he's going to need our help," he yelled perilously, but Levi's sudden, unfriendly stare remained gazing at him from afar. His arms were down against his sides atop the reeling bridge. Jack's gaping eyes carefully watched him standing there, as the bridge walloped violently in the wind. Immediately, Jack was knocked backwards against the stone surface. The unremitting, rolling wind began to gust against his stiff face. "Hurry, Levi, the wind is becoming much too brutal for him to be standing along the mountainside." His unemotional, wintry eyes, the eyes of a staggering human, remained staring back, from within the squalling winds. Jack suddenly thrust towards him, taking diligent steps against the relentless wind pounding into him. "This is suicide, man, come on. Help him, we need to get him before things become more intense, it's not safe up here," he cried, but his voice was muffled against the hurricane surrounding the two, from above. Dead Man's Rocker began to seesaw not far from him, as he approached him. That dreadful sound of wood reverberating against the knotted ropes began to fill him with fear, utmost fear. His chest continued to race, panicking. Inside he wondered curiously about Levi's sudden ignorance. "Dude, what's your problem? Your attitude, what's the deal? Your brother's in danger and you're standing here like your shit doesn't stink," he shrieked, finally reaching the ropes closest to him. He peered out into the vast canyons underneath the wobbling bridge. The cavernous canyons were lightless below and seemed to never end. He trembled, peering outward into the vast mountain range. Levi's still body rocked along it, holding on to both sides of the suspended bridge. The ropes began to twist and splinter underneath his frozen hands. It was as if it were built against the forbidding sky, miraculously stretching across to another summit outlooking the two boys. "Answer me, what's gotten into you? Are you all right, Levi? I'm coming over to you," Jack wailed, immediately clasping his fingers around the swaying ropes. He cautiously stepped onto the aging board, approaching Levi. The wood began to buckle against the jarring wind blowing at them both, causing him to panic. He suddenly clenched his arms against the posts. "I'm hella scared, man, just came to me, and we can get Josiah," he hollered towards him in the distance. Levi's face was unmoving as he stood straight ahead, above the threatening canyons below. Jack glared at him, again, stepping onto the unsteady boards. "You're coming with me, if you like it or not. Josiah is your flesh and blood and he needs you now more than ever," Jack cried into the strapping wind. "Okay, I can do this," he thought, taking watchful steps further on to the swinging bridge. "I'm coming out, came towards me, Levi," he shrieked, suddenly losing his courage. He steadied himself against the ropes, pushing outwards in an attempt to keep it from joggling. "Levi, stop with the game, I'm not in any mood to die today," he shouted towards him, yards away. Levi remained staring at him, swinging against the hand-tied ropes. The wind continued to punish him as he stood tight-lipped. "What about Madison? What? Now you're giving up? What about your brothers and sisters awaiting us at the plantation? He wailed, sounding nervous. Finally, he released his grip along the ancient ropes. One hand remained against the knotted bridge, as he extended his arm forward, towards Levi. He neared the center where Levi stood, eyes cold against the wind. Immediately, a treacherous gust of air rolled against the two swinging overhead. We're a moment from a storm, Levi, I can feel it in my fingers, whatever it is, whatever's troubling you. Let it go. Jack shouted, straining his throat. He was staring at him, 20 feet from the center where Levi clung stock still against the sides. Suddenly, the suspended bridge was hit again with a forceful gust of frigid wind, toppling off Levi's top hat into the sky above. It blew against the surging wind, immediately cascading downwards into the canyons. Forget the hat, we're next if you don't hurry, now! He cried, sluggishly moving towards the center. He stood face to face towards an unfamiliar Levi, a much different Levi from the one he remembered in the barn. Instantaneously, Levi's right hand left the rope, and he burst out laughing. Josiah, do you think Jack's ready? Is it time to spill myself to him? He called out. Jack suddenly spun to see Josiah standing behind in the distance. Somehow he stood above the summit unscathed, unharmed and staring at the two. Jack turned again, facing Levi, who continued to snicker at him. I'll start by admitting to you, there isn't a Madison, there isn't any worthless plantation down there, I made it all up, Jack. He shouted at him, rocking above the canyons. It's completely burned down, gone, finito. He cried facing him. Jack's eyes fought to stay open, the wind was carrying into them, forcing the bridge to quiver tirelessly. Why? You are lying to me? I don't understand, replied Jack, feeling confused. Levi shrugged his shoulders, holding himself against the ropes. Michael, I think Jack is ready, are you ready, Jack? He asked him, glaring into his eyes. Jack said nothing, standing motionless in the wind as it pummeled the bridge. You caught me, Jack, there isn't anybody here named Josiah, never had been, we had never been part of any stinking Amish colony either, you see. My brother Michael and I are runaways. Fucking castaways, Jack. He uttered, running his fingers against his black button shirt. I stolen these clothes from a Amish family, one I slaughtered on my way to that barn you found us in. How do I look? Do I play the part? He asked him, leering, slowly stepping towards him. Jack stood there speechless awaiting him. Michael remained on the stone surface, peering from behind. Chapter 16 When Levi clutched onto the ropes, sliding his hands along as he came closer to Jack, the mom wish kids didn't have a clue. Jack. You should have seen how fearful they were, they would have followed me to the end of the earth if I told them to, he said, staring straight into Jack's wondering eyes. It's like this, Jack, we never fit in with the social class, we just adapt and play along with the role we're given, you know. I really like you, Jack. But there's something I can't hide from you, not anymore, and in a way I want you to know I killed your father, and I'd probably do it again if I could, nothing against him or you, he shouted, facing him. Jack stared at him, unable to move further or speak, tongue-tied, with his eyes gaping at him, until suddenly he shrieked into the ferocious wind. No, it couldn't have been. It was you? The whole time? I believed you were my true friend. He cried, but the Levi he remembered was lost. A cold, calculated individual now stood before him. The face of evil peered at him, without hesitation, sympathy, or any sign of regret. You're not right, Levi, you need help, you're sick. Jack hollered towards him, standing tightly against the shaking ropes. Levi approached him slowly as the slats underneath him shook. The persisting wind howled surrounding them, viciously smacking into the bridge. Jack glared at him, now standing in dead silence, horribly deceived and cheated. The only person he had trusted since that terrible blast, had double-crossed him, he had befriended the only person who could have preserved his father's life, The thought of it was unthinkable. His face was frozen, tears slowly trickled from his face onto the wood slats below. Holding tightly against the braided ropes, he glared at Levi. "I killed an innocent boy back there? This is how you wrong me?" Jack cried, devastated, fearing and anguish. "I thought sooner or later you would catch on, that I'm no closer to being Amish than you are. It's power, you know, the way it feels having the world at your mercy," he wailed, cautiously stepping across the boards. He was now more than half the distance to him. "After I poisoned both of my biological parents, social workers fought to find us a replacement family, a new start. Life's a twist, I must say," he hollered, feet from him. "I won't allow you to hurt anyone else, you hear me?" Jack shouted, trembling as he stood stationary. He glanced back at Michael, Josiah, whoever he was, he no longer knew. Michael remained not far away, with his hands clenched around the posts of the wobbly bridge. His hat was off, blowing against the dirt. He remained staring at the two, inactive, watching everything unravel and come into light. Jack's eyes studied Levi as he took another step. "Stay away from me, you're dead, I won't warn you again," he cried, tightening his grip along the streaming rope. "What? Now I'm the sick one?" Levi shouted. "I guess having homosexuals like Murray and Georgie as a replacement for my own guardians should have made my life a hell of a lot easier, huh? As if my bloodline couldn't have gotten any more screwed up. Comma, well, we weren't exactly blood related, but you know where I'm getting at, and if you're wondering, they never touched Michael or I," he uttered. The wind behind him continued to roll and howl. "It's just funny the state would give them ass wives to small children the way they had. I'm not going to say they weren't abusive, hell, they were more than that, they were downright sinister. Maybe it taught me something in some outlandish way, maybe I respected that about them. Who knows?" he yelled, facing him. Jack remained against the boards, where his feet quivered in the cold wind. "You killed them too, didn't you, Levi? And the others at the church. Was it you? I'm starting to see the picture now, you were in our little clique, weren't you?" He then paused. "Killing tiny helpless children, mothers, fathers, what the fuck else have you done? What have you done? Answer me. Comma, did you hurt them kids back at the barn?" Jack questioned him, with his mind running sporadically at the thought of Levi's sudden change. "It's white man's magic, Jack, being up here, this is where I found myself," Levi replied, closing in on him. "It's up to you now, that's it. Jack, just close your eyes and wait for me," he said, pulling his hands from the rope. Jack's eyes shut momentarily, imagining all of the Levi's terrible monstrosities. The world below, the death that had taken over the countryside, cities ravished, cannibalism, pointless crimes, skeletons of children, babies, inconceivable bodies piled against one another, the world around him raging in blackness, fires, the graveyard of death awaiting him, families gone, all of it lost forever. It all came to him, standing on Dead Man's Rocker. Immediately, he began to open his eyes. Without warning, Levi pounced against him, battering him to the ground, dropping against the hard timber. His eyes opened to find Levi's body on top of his, along the rickety planks, both scrambling to the death, thousands of feet above the darkness below. Levi's frigid hands grappled around his throat, cutting his air. He struggled to break loose, tangling his shoes against the ropes just above the wooden slats, unable to free himself. "You're important to us, Jack, very fucking important," Levi shouted, with his hulking fingers tightening around him, choking the life from him. Jack could only see his glacial stare, unemotional, glaring into his eyes as he fought underneath him. "Die, fucking die, you're a waste, Jack, you're nothing. Comma, this mountain craves your sweet blood, now feed the fucking mountain, Jack," Levi yelled above him, screaming in the brutal wind. Suddenly, squirming against the wood, finally he freed his foot from the aging ropes. Jack kicked into him, missing the first. Levi continued to throw violent punches, suddenly hitting him in the abdomen, knocking the wind from his depleted chest. "Desmond is thirsting for your blood, Jack. Give him what he wants," he clamored, as Jack fought to breath, clawing at Levi's fingers against his neck. "Come with me, Jack, let's visit death," he shouted, yanking Jack from the ground along his back. He pulled his head through the ropes. Levi's fingers were still smothering his airway, as he squirmed, unable to get up. "Take another look, Dead Man's Rocker isn't just another viewpoint for tourists. This is a special place unlike anything you've ever seen. The omen is real, Jack," he hollered, pushing him further out into the canyons below. Jack was fighting to breath, but his throat had been smashed. His arms and legs were limp as he peered out into the rasping wind. "It's time you visit your mother and your father. Desmond will make sure you won't die in vain. The settlers believed this mountain as a place of offering, and truthfully, I've always been curious if the story holds any validation. I assume your sacrifice will be as fruitful as the last, Jack. Goodbye." Jack's eyes closed again, motionless. He laid against the weather-beaten ropes overhead, hanging out into the cold. A moment from death, above the razor-edged rocks, and vast darkness below the mountainside. Levi gripped his throat again, his fingers were trembling in fury, as he manhandled Jack's lifeless body out into the sky. Jack's arms were sliding behind him. Levi continued to thrust, using all of his strength to get him through the old ropes, shuddering against the weather. Jack's body was half on and half off, leaning over into the open sky, from the quaking boards. A moment from slipping over, Levi stopped dragging him, crouched against the wood, tossing both of his arms over in front of him, as they dangled freely towards the canyon beneath the two. Jack closed his eyes, preparing for his death. With his legs outright against the wooden planks, he could see everything clearly. There was nothing left inside of him, to fight, to survive. The earth was desolate and dark, and the others who ran it were just as dark. "Good riddance, Jack," Levi whispered, giving him one final shove. He began to slip from the bridge, as his stomach caught the splintering wood. He was falling over, as his legs came closer to the shivering ropes. Immediately, the ropes shook wildly, convulsing behind him. Springing from side to side as the wind cut through the bridge, sending a blood-curdling squeal out into the massive canyons prodding up at him. Jack quickly stared downwards into the dark, where a unanticipated Levi had fallen to his abrupt death. Unable to move, he dangled from the ropes and the wood, fighting to turn over. A pair of icy hands immediately grabbed onto him, and began to jerk him back onto the bridge. Seconds later, the chilling hands had left him, and everything became serene and silent, except for the dying wind surrounding Dead Man's Rocker. Jack spun around against the H planks, surprisingly, finding Michael squatting at the other end, peering out into the vast space beneath them. Jack stared at him, wondering heavily about the life he would leave behind, now that he was alone, without Levi. That sudden moment, Jack perched beside him, along the bridge, with his legs overhanging out into the vast wilderness. Both boys attentively studying the stagnant wind around them, and how strange it was, and how it had turned peaceful within minutes. Michael sat a moment as he sat beside him, reflecting, then humanely turned his eyes at him. Without any hesitation, he put his arm around Jack, silently glaring out into a new world. "So this is it? This is what it feels like?" he asked Jack at his side. Jack's eyes fixed against the canyons below, where miles descended into total darkness. He then peered at him, nodding, responding with three simple, yet meaningful words, "It sure does." The end.